Hare Krishna. Welcome to the Bhagavatam class this morning. We're going to do the 10th canto, 2nd chapter, verse 22. 22nd verse of the 2nd chapter of the 10th canto. Sa esh jivan khalu sampareto. वर्तेत यो अत्यंत नृशंसितेन देहे मृते तं मनुजाशपन्ति गंता तमो अंध तमु मानिनो ध्रुव स ही एष दैट जेलस पर्सन जीवन वाइल लिविंग खलु इवन Sampreta is dead. Varteta continues to live. Ya, anyone who Atyanta, very much. Nrishami sitena, by executing cruel activities. Dehe, when the body, mrute, is finished. Tam, him, manuja, all human beings, sapanti, condemn. Ganta, he will go. Tama andam, to hellish life. Tanu manina, of a person in the bodily concept of life. Dhruvam, without a doubt. Translation. A person who is very cruel is regarded as dead even while living. For while he is living or after his death, everyone condemns him. And after death of a person, in the bodily concept of life, he is undoubtedly transferred to the hell known as Andhatama. Purport by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada. Srila Prabhupada ki. The Mataji is back there making garlands, does not give you a right to speak in the middle of the class. Please maintain silence. Unless if you have a question. Kansa considered that if he killed his sister while living, he would be condemned by everyone. And after death, he would go to the darkest region of the hellish life because of his cruelty. It is said that a cruel person is like a butcher, is advised not to live and not to die. While living, a cruel person creates hellish conditions for his next birth, and therefore he should not live. But he is also advised not to die because after that he must go to the darkest region of hell. Thus, in either circumstances, he is condemned. Kansa, therefore, having good sense about science of the soul transmigration, deliberately refrained from killing Devaki. This is a full two-page purport. We'll take this much and then take the rest after. Om Agyanti Mirandasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chakshurunmilitam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Shri Chaitanya Manovishtam Sthapitam Yena Bhutale Swayam Rupah Kadamayam Dadati Swapadantikam He Krishna Karuna Sindho Dina Bandho Jagatpate Gopesha Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namostute Tapta Kanchana Gaurangi Radhe Vrindavaneshwari Vrishabhanu Sute Devi Pranamami Hari Priye Vanchaka Upatarubhyascha Kripa Sindubhya Evacha Titanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhara Shivasadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Hare Krishna. Thank you very much. So this verse is although spoken by Srila Shukdev Goswami, but Shukdev Goswami is expressing the thoughts that are going through the minds of Kansa. Kansa sees that Devaki is just glowing. She is looking so beautiful and so shiny, and she is not afraid of Kansa. So he is suspecting that now the Supreme Personality of Godhead has entered her womb. So now is a good time to kill her so that the Supreme Personality of Godhead in her womb will also be killed. But then he is having another thought of cruelty. So this verse deals with that cruelty that even a person like Kamsa is hesitating. Kamsa is just about as cruel as they come. But even he is hesitating with this cruelty, having to kill Devaki, who is his sister, and right now pregnant, and in his shelter, completely in his ashraya. You should not be killing anybody in your ashraya. Should not be killing a sister, period. And should not be killing a woman, and on top of that, a pregnant woman. Any cruelty against women is condemnable, but cruelty against pregnant women is even more condemnable, according to the Shastra, as well as people's minds on the street. That if a woman in any public area is disrespected, it is not such a big news, but if a pregnant woman is disrespected, it becomes a bigger news. So it's a higher system. So Srila Prabhupada in the purport is saying, Kansa considered that if he killed his sister while living, he would be condemned by everyone, and after death he would go to the darkest region of hellish life, which is called Andhatama, hell. It is said that a cruel person is like a butcher. The Srila Prabhupada is trying to make a point here of why different blessings for different people. Why a butcher's son should not live, because he will only give pain to others. And why he should not die, because if and when he dies, he will be subject to all that pain that he gave. So I want to have you hear this 5-minute story directly from His Divine Grace, explaining this different blessings for different people. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna. Thank you very much. So hear from His Divine Grace directly. This is exactly the matter that's given in this purport. Srila Prabhupada is explaining it separately in another lecture. Here it's just a little tale mentioned, and here you'll hear the whole story. This is relating to Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur. Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur's disappearance of Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur's was coming up, maybe the first disappearance, and he's trying to explain to his disciples as to how a disappearance of an acharya is a matter of celebration. So in that matter, he's giving this story about one guru giving different blessings to different people depending upon who they are. It's very interesting. Please hear carefully, directly from His Divine Grace.
As I told you, that sadhava jivo ma marova. There are a nice story that I told you, that a saint
So says Rajaputra Chiranjeevi, live for a long time, because after you finish this life, you're going to have to face the consequences, may not be the prince in the next life and so on. If you are a devotee, Majiva is your blessing. The sooner you leave when you are fixed in Krishna consciousness, the better. And for the butcher, as the example in this purport, the blessing is don't live and don't die. It's a little technical matter, so I thought His Divine Grace will explain it to you much better. While living, a cruel person creates hellish condition, and therefore he should not live, but therefore advised not to die, because after death he must go to the darkest region of the hell. That's what Kansa is thinking, that if I kill Devaki, I will go to the darkest region of the hell. Thus, in either circumstance, he is condemned. Kansa, therefore, having good sense about science of soul's transmigration, deliberately refrained from killing Devaki. Any questions so far on this aspect? Then we go to the next. No questions? Okay. In this verse, the words Ganta Tamo Andham Tanu Manino Dhruvam are very important and require extensive understanding. Srila Jiv Goswami in the Vaishnava Toshni Tika says, Tatra Tanu Manina Papina Iti Dehatma Buddheva Papa Vinasho Bhavati. One who lives in the bodily concept, thinking, I am this body, involves himself by very nature of this conception. In a life of sinful activities, anyone living in such a conception is to be considered a candidate for hell. Who's the candidate for hell? Person who's living a life in bodily concept, that I am this body, and when this body ends, I end. And that would be the end of all. That person here quoted by Srila Prabhupada, Jiva Goswami quoted by Srila Prabhupada, is destined to hell. Next example, Srila Prabhupada actually usually is a purport, but the purport of this verse, Srila Prabhupada actually gave a whole lecture. So, further, he's explaining from Srimad Bhagavatam, 7th canto, 5th chapter, 30th verse. The verse is Adanta gobhir visatam tamashram punah punas charvita charvananam. One who is in the bodily concept of life has no control over sense gratification. So there's a further explanation of why this person is going to go to hell, because he is in the bodily concept of life, that this verse explains, because that person has no control over sense gratification. The karmis, the so-called karmis, they just want to enjoy their senses to the fullest. Who knows what is going to be tomorrow? Just enjoy, just do it. Enjoy your senses to the fullest, the most that you can. Such a person can do anything sinful, to eat, drink, and be merry, and enjoy a life of sense gratification, not knowing the soul's transmigration from one body to another. Such a person does whatever he likes, whatever he imagines, and therefore, being subject to the laws of nature, he suffers miserably again and again in different material bodies. End of the translation. Then Srila Prabhupada is giving another verse from Srimad Bhagavatam, 5th canto, 5th chapter, and 5th verse. Easy to memorize. 555. Or 555. Yavat kriyastavad idam manove karmatmakam yena sharira baddha. In the bodily concept of life, a person karmanubandha. A person is karmanubandha, or conditioned by karma, and as long as mind is absorbed in karma, one must accept a material body, sharira bandha. Bondage in this material body is the source of misery, kleshada. The source of misery, we have three kinds of miseries. Why do we have them? Because we are in this body. Sharira baddha. As long as we are in this body, the material body, it will be subject to all the kleshas. Next verse Srila Prabhupada is quoting. Doesn't say where it's coming from. Nasadhu manye yata atmanoyam asanna api klesha da esha deha. although the body is temporary, it always gives one trouble in many ways. But human civilization is now unfortunately based on tanumani, the bodily concept of life, by which one thinks, I belong to this nation, I belong to this group, I belong to that group, and so on. Each of us has his own ideas, and we are becoming increasingly involved individually, socially, communally, nationally, in the complexities of karmanubandha, sinful activities. For the maintenance of the body, men are killing so many other bodies and becoming implicated in karmanubandha. Therefore, Srila Jiv Goswami says, tanumani, those in the bodily concept of life are papi, sinful persons. For such sinful persons, the ultimate destination is the darkest region of hellish life, ganta tamo andam. In particular, a person who wants to maintain his body by killing animals is most sinful and cannot understand the values of spiritual life. Reminds me, I've never seen or met Srila Prabhupada, but other devotees tell me that in private conversations, if a devotee left the ashram and go out and doing something else, Srila Prabhupada did not consider them looped until or unless that person goes back to eating meat. If a person who so-called quote-unquote looped and at least is maintaining a vegetarian status, this is of course in the West, in India it is no big accomplishment for anybody to remain vegetarian. It is no accomplishment at all. Even following four regulator principles, many people just do it. It's getting less and less, but nevertheless, in the Western countries, following four regulator principles is a big deal. It is a very huge matter. So, as long as a devotee is at least maintaining vegetarianism, it is not that we are the International Society for Vegetarian Consciousness. It's not that, but it's just the understanding that we should not be committing any more pap. We have committed so much pap before by eating so many animals. And that realization, okay, now at least I stop eating meat, stop generating more and more and more of that karma that's going to make me karmanubandha further and further into pap kind of life. So further, Srila Prabhupada says, this is only a 1 hour class, and this the purport of this class is like needs 2 to 3 hours to explain, and I'm trying to cram it in, so please bear with me. We are done with 3/4 of the purport. 1/4 is still left. In Bhagavad Gita 16:19-20, the Lord says, tan aham dusita kruran सोमरेषु नरादमा क्षिपामि अग्रसं अशुभान् अशुश्रिव एव योनिषु आसुरिं योनिम् अपन्ना मूढजन्मानि जन्मनि माम् अपरायव कौन्तेय ततो यन्ति अधमं गतिम्. Those who are envious and mischievous, who are the lowest among men, are cast by me into the ocean of material existence, into various demoniac species of life, attaining repeated birth among the species of demoniac life. Such persons can never approach me. Gradually, they sink down to the most abominable type of existence. A human being is meant to understand the value of human life, which is a boon obtained after many, many births. Therefore, one must free oneself from tanomani, the bodily concept of life, and realize the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Okay, we only have 15 minutes, so if there is any questions we can take regarding all this, or I can explain this further. I could explain this further for another 3 hours, but what aspect of it you would like to hear about, I rather take that aspect than anything that I pick. Any concept, any aspect that you would like further explained? 1 minute. Yes.
When we are following one sampradaya, one group of spiritual activity, sometimes we think we are following the best, we are the best one following a spiritual activity. We are so much attached to that group or that sampradaya. And sometimes we are criticizing other sampradayas or other systems of spiritual activity. That may also lead to karmanubandhi. That is also like bodily conscious or karmanubandha, because we are so much attached to one form of spiritual activities or one sampradaya.
Yes. So the question is that if we are in one sampradaya, sometimes we criticize other sampradayas, and that may cause us more bondage, more karmanubandha. So Srila Prabhupada gave clear answer to that. Many times when he criticized others, he said, "I can do it, you cannot." So when we so-called criticize them, we never criticize, we should not be criticizing them on our own. We should be quoting the acharyas. We should not be making our own statements to condemn somebody else, some other spiritual or religious organization or concept or philosophy. We should not ourselves be making derogatory comments on them, because we are not spiritually advanced enough to do that. But whatever we do to explain that concept, we quote the acharyas. We quote Srila Prabhupada, Srila Prabhupada quotes Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati, Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati quotes Bhaktivinoda Thakur, and so on. Many of us quote directly Jeev Goswami, Rupa Goswami, Sanatana Goswami. We don't want to even get into thinking. Even mentally, we don't want to be fault-finding in them. We want to have all respect for them from a distance. And if we chastise them or say anything derogatory, we should be quoting the acharyas, not ourselves. Okay.
Prabhu, you were speaking about the papa, sinful activities. So the materialist person, they don't think that they are committing these sinful activities. Whatever they are doing, they think it was stemming from their parampara. Their parampara, their forefathers, they are doing all those things, they are doing those things, and they never think that they are committing any sins. So what do you think about them? What do you say about them?
About who? Who are you talking about? People?
General materialist person.
General materialist person committing pap.
Yeah, whatever they are doing, they are doing because of our forefathers are doing, so we are controlling those things.
Yeah.
So they do that, but they don't understand it because it is a sin or not.
Okay, so there is a clear story in the Bhagavatam regarding Mrigari, the hunter, and Narad Muni. So when Narad Muni was going through the jungle and he found that so many animals have been half killed here and they are suffering, they are not killed enough to leave their bodies and they are suffering in between, he questioned, who is this? Who is doing this to the animals, making them suffer like this? And Mrigari showed up. They're mine. I do it to them. I like them. I like to see them suffering like this. It gives me great pleasure. And when Narad Muni tried to stop him, he said, oh, I am a shikari, I am a hunter. My forefathers have always done this. I come from a family of hunters. This is what we do. So Narad Muni explained, even if you come from the family of hunters, you are still going to carry your own karma. Your forefathers are not going to take your karma away. You're going to have to, if you make the other animals suffer or kill them, you're going to have to carry the karma for all those animals. It is not that just because you come from a family of the hunters, that your forefathers were hunters, they will take your karma. No, they will not. You are an individual spirit soul who is responsible for own karma, and you must suffer from that. And Mrigari finally surrendered and approached Narad Muni and said, oh, by the way, this is how I make my living also. So I don't know how to do anything else. I only know how to kill animals, and that's the only way I make my living. What am I going to do now? So Narad Muni said, take a tulsi plant, come to the bank of the river, put a tulsi plant in front, make a little hut, and your wife, your griha, you reside there, and I will look after your food and all that. And the whole village found out Mrigari the hunter has become so religious, so spiritual. Now he is worshipping Tulsi instead of killing the animals and living on the bank of the river, always chanting the holy name, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. And this Tulsi and the holy name completely transformed this Mrigari into a person who doesn't even want to kill an ant now, wants to not even step on an ant, because he's become so, from Krura, he's become Akrura. There is always a debate in Vraja was krura, was akrura actually krura or akrura? Because the gopis always say he is not akrura, he is krura. But the Shastra says, no, he was akrura. Okay? Thank you. Any other question? Yes.
Hare Krishna.
Ravan and Kansa? I can't understand what you're speaking. Can somebody understand?
Kansa, in your eating many breathing things like the daily rituals and activities, so sometimes you stop the thing of the killing. And again, he killed them. He kills many children than before. And then if you stop the sometimes also the problems with the killing of this daily rituals, the activities they have done. So
yes. Yes.
So,
what is the question? Why they stop committing sinful activities and then they start sinful activities? They do it again. They stop and they do it again. Yes, because they are known to be jnanis. They have the jnan from this verse. You can tell that Kansa knows that he is going to go to the darkest region of the hellish life and he doesn't want to go there. So that's why he stopped from killing Devaki. So your question is probably that then why did he kill? One thing is Devaki is not a direct threat to him. Whereas these children may be or could be because of the Akashvani saying that one of these children will kill you. So ate the child, but then when he started forgiving all the other, Vasudev promised Kansa that I will give you all children born of them. So when he went to give the first child of Devaki to Kansa, Kansa said, well, it's okay, take him back. You can raise him. But Narad Muni did not like that for several reasons. That made Vasudev and Devaki very happy. And they started to think, oh, Kansa is not all that cruel. He is allowing us to keep this child and so on. And the other reason is also, last time I was giving a class here, somebody asked the question, one Mataji asked about the six other children of Devaki. So these six other children of Devaki were the grandchildren of Hiranyakashyap, who actually went to perform tapasya to Lord Brahma, and Lord Brahma gave them a boon that they will not be killed by any charanas, siddhas, yakshas, devi devatas, and so on. But when Hiranyakashyap found out, he curse them that your father Kalnemi will kill all six of you. This is Hiranyakashyap's curse to his six grandchildren. And Kalnemi is now Kamsa. And those six grandchildren are now going to take birth from Devaki's womb. And they are destined to be killed by the hands of Kamsa. Kamsa is actually their father from the previous life. So this Leela also has to go on. The shrap, that curse on Hiranyakashyap, the curse on these six children by Hiranyakashyap is also going to carry on. So Kalnaimi is now Kamsa, and those six children are now one by one taking birth from Devaki's womb, and as one by one they take birth, he's killing them all. It's given right here in the end of the chapter 1, 10th canto, chapter 1. In the end, there is additional notes on this chapter by Srila Prabhupada. It says, formerly an asura named Kalnaimi had six sons named so and so. They are called the six garbhas. So the pastime I told you is right here. If you have the same Bhagavatam, it's on 112 and 113 page, or these notes are like 20 pages long. The second last page, this concept is explained, the six garbhas, who they were, what they were. So coming back to your question, he had this like a good thought that, okay, I will not kill Devaki. But then he killed all those six children anyways. That was destiny also. But as it is, in this body, they are your own nephews. And they're just born, and you're killing them, hitting them against the rock. So you must carry the karma for that. So destiny also, and mind is always changing, flickering. It's not that one has the knowledge. There is knowledge, and then there is the application of that knowledge. I know that I'm going to suffer in the hellish planets because of doing this, but sometimes or the other, my mind still convinces me to do it. So that is something that a living entity is always suffering from. We are not completely steady. We know what is wrong, what is right, but we still sometimes knowingly do what is wrong than what is right. To an extent, we are not, the assembly here of devotees, not as bad as Kamsa, but not even close, but somewhere or the other, knowing what is right and what is wrong, we still sometimes get convinced by our mind to do the wrong thing. And that's why Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati said, the way to control that mind is get up in the morning, pick up your shoe and beat that mind 100 times, and before going to bed at night, beat that mind 100 times with a stick. And that would be the way to control the mind. Okay? Thank you. Jagadguru Srila Prabhupada ki Nitai Gaur Premanande Grantra Shrimad Bhagavatam ki Shri Shri Krishna Balaram ki Shri Radha Shyam Sundar Bhagwan ki Shri Gaur Nitai ki ISKCON Vrindavan ki. All glories to the assembled devotees. All glories to the assembled devotees. All glories to the assembled devotees. All glories to Sri Guru and Sri Gauranga.